his adopted son, he bought a violin for Jackie Justice and a German flute. Now, I'm not a violin player, but a violin was very much a man's instrument, as was the German flute. I do have a German flute. German flute simply means the transverse version of the wind instruments we think of today. They were made out of wood in the old days. They would have had ivory fittings. The fittings are what hold the three parts of it together. A modern flute today, of course, is made out of metal. Sometimes silver, sometimes gold. Got to play a gold flute once. That was kind of fun. It's a hard instrument to play. The common flute of the day was this one, which we think of today as a
recorder.
Sure. So, for your kids, if there's a music class in your school and they do recorder, say, nope, don't call it recorder, call it flute, or English flute, or common flute. These are very easy to play. These are much harder to play. You have to fashion your lips across the sound hole to generate a pitch. And there's much more opportunity for mistakes, as I just demonstrated. Okay, so Washington then bought a violin and a German flute for Jackie. For Patsy, he bought this fan. This is a feminine instrument. Later on, Nellie Custis, I'll show you this, the adopted granddaughter, he bought her an English guitar. I'll talk about and demonstrate that a little bit later. But so amongst the upper classes, we have some instruments that are just unobtainable for others. We have a musical style that, did anyone recognize that song? Don't think so. Did anyone recognize this song that I played though? Here we go around the mulberry bush, good. Any other sets of words? This is a tune that the Washingtons knew and played here at Mount Vernon. Come on, they're five at least.
Five?
Think about it. You know, but like preschool, this is the way you brush your teeth, right? Comb your hair. Or perhaps at Christmas time, I saw three ships come sailing in, or Lazy Mary, will you get up? There are lots of them. And this represents sort of the other extreme of music surrounding Washington. And that is and Jefferson would have been more of this harpsichord world, right? You know, Jefferson was a musician. He played the violin. And he had a harpsichord. He bought English guitars for his daughters as well. And so Jefferson, like Washington, they knew the importance of music as a sort of an upper-class expression. But the trouble with an upper-class cultural expression is it doesn't necessarily connect to the other people. And it doesn't necessarily express what the other people are thinking. So let me take a couple of tunes that are actually very highly expressive. And I'll begin with this mulberry bush tune.